Welcome back to another episode of the Restaurant Management Series. Today, I'm going to be teaching you step-by-step how to calculate food costs in your restaurant. Hello everyone, this is Jen with Garnish TV, and in this video, I'm going to cover exactly how to calculate your food cost percentage to optimize your expenses and improve your profitability. So, let's get started. Step number one, calculate your total cost of goods sold. Just as a refresher, your total cost of goods sold refers to how much food and drink you've sold within a certain accounting period. Depending on your restaurant, this could be on a weekly, bi-weekly, or monthly basis. Based on your accounting period, you're going to plug in specific inventory values into the cost of goods sold formula. This can be found by subtracting the ending inventory value from the sum of the beginning inventory value and purchased inventory value. Start by writing down the value of your current inventory from canned goods to raw ingredients. Then add the cost of any additional inventory you ordered within the accounting period at hand. At the end of the accounting period, take note of the value of the remaining stock and subtract this value from the previous sum. For example, if at the beginning of your accounting cycle you have $900 worth of inventory and you order 600 more, your total inventory value is $1,500. Then at the end of the period, you count and find you now only have $700 in inventory. Subtract the $700 from the previous inventory value of $1,500 to get your total cost of goods sold at $800. This means you sold $800 worth of inventory. If you have an established inventory management system, these calculations are automatically done for you, which can make your life a whole lot easier. Inventory solutions, such as today's sponsor, Zip Inventory, automatically updates the cost of goods sold with every stock order and every customer sale, saving you the time of doing manual calculations. Step number two, calculate the total income from the same accounting period. Next, you need to see exactly how much revenue you have generated within the same cycle. Again, if you already have a modern point of sale system, this information should already be calculated for you. If not, simply check your books and add up all the sales you closed within the period in question. Step three, divide the cost of goods sold by the total income. Now, all you have to do is divide the cost of goods sold from step one by the total revenue from step two. This will give you your food costs in decimal form. So let's say your total income for the accounting period was $3,200. In this case, we would divide 800 by 3,200, which would give us 0.25. Step number four, multiply the quotient by 100. To get your food cost in percentage form, simply multiply the value from step three by 100. Now you have your total food cost percentage. In our example, this would be 0.25 times 100, which is 25%. While this is the most common method for calculating food costs, you can also calculate the cost per dish. To do this, simply divide the total cost it takes to make a dish by the retail price times 100. This gives you the total food cost percentage per dish. However, this method is more time consuming as you must perform calculations for each specific menu item and all of its variants. Therefore, to get a more general sense of food expenses, you should first calculate the total food cost percentage. And there are the four simple steps for calculating your food cost percentage. Pretty easy, right? Make sure you repeat this process on a regular basis so you can actively monitor price fluctuations and expense rates. This enables you to fine-tune your budgets and adjust menu prices as needed. Understanding your food cost also allows you to cross-examine your average inventory expenses with competitors to determine if you are exceeding typical spending habits. If you do find that your food cost is eating into your bottom line, you can further evaluate your supplier relationships to determine if you can source inventory at cheaper rates. I hope you found this video on calculating food costs to be helpful. If you did, please give it a like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, because next week we're discussing how to properly count food inventory so you can optimize inventory control in your restaurant. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you next time.